Hi everyone, Larry Snow here, and in this video, we're going to be taking a look at an app called Social Bearing. Social Bearing provides insights and analytics for Twitter, but it applies it right on a map. So the search results, anything you find, will be geolocated to a particular map. Now, the geolocation is a little off, so the longitude and latitude is off just to protect privacy. But this is a good tool, I think, for the protection professional for an open source intelligence tool. So let's take a look. We're over here on socialbearing.com. And we have our inputs right here. Find tweets, find a handle or look up a handle. Geo, which we're going to spend a little time on. People, followers, and friends. And here are some of the social bearing features, but you can take a look at that when you come to the website. So for us, we're going to be taking a look at Geo. Let me click on the Geo tab. It'll refresh. Now we can put in keywords or hashtags, or we can just go right to the location. So I'm just going to go right to the location, and I'm going to type in... Let's just start with something simple here, and we're going to take a look at, let's say, Boston, Mass. We'll select a location. We'll say OK. And we click Search. Now, one of the things that social bearing has to be in compliance with is Twitter's API. So when you do use this, either you use a throwaway type of Twitter account, or you use a unofficial Twitter account if you want to stay that way, or you can use your actual Twitter account, which is what I'm going to do. Doesn't matter either way. It's only going to read your bio and stuff, and that is required by Twitter because Twitter wants to know who's using its data. Okay, so here's your geofence, this circle. And I can turn that on or off over here on the user interface. Now, one of the things that we didn't take a look at in the previous video was sentiment. And Twitter does provide that in the advanced search, but it has a nice, social bearing puts it together in a nice package here with the color codes. So you can take a look at what's the sentiment is terrible. And they pick up on keywords like never, frozen. Let's try another one. Now this is a traffic. So blocked, stop, delay. Those are called negative or terrible sentiments. The great is the bright green. And so they look at grow and backbone. I like the fact that the keywords are highlighted. And let's take a look at good, work, Super Bowl, Patriots, hello. So you get the idea, right? So you can have in a geolocation area, and I did 2 kilometers from the central location of Boston, Massachusetts. And these are pretty near time. This is 12 minutes ago. 29 minutes ago, 19 minutes ago, 42 minutes ago. So it's pretty near time. I can zoom in a little bit and get a little bit more detail on all of these here. But, so that's good, right? So you're clicking around, you're clicking on each one. But the great thing with social bearing is, if I scroll down, look at this. It gives you percentages. It gives you the source. So tweet my jobs, that Twitter handle is 29% of the traffic in Boston right now. Top domains shared. Tweets over time. Gives you a hashtag cloud, a word cloud for that area that we just did the geo location on. And then it gives you all of the tweets. That the ones I was just clicking on, it gives you all the tweets right in a nice dashboard view, and you can take a look at who's following them back, you know, followers, what's the reach. So great insight here. even from a social media marketing perspective, but more so from an open source intelligence perspective, you get to see the connections of the people, right? Not in a matrix kind of form, but certainly you can go that way. And also, we also have down here languages. So this is a fantastic resource for your investigations or open source intelligence, protective intelligence. And over here on the left side, we have just the pictures. So it narrows it down. So we did all tweet types, right? That was that big chunk we saw. And I just clicked on pictures over here on the left side, and it shows only the pictures, only the tweets that have pictures in them. Only links, only verified accounts, and then all of the tweets again. Another feature that this has over here is that it'll refresh every 10 seconds. It'll refresh up to 2,000 tweets. So if I click on that button, it will have a nice countdown. Let me click off of that. Just wait for that to refresh. Okay, it says 8 new tweets found. And again, you can scroll down, zoom in, zoom out, scroll down, see what the latest tweets are. Now, every single, so that's still on. So every 10 seconds, that's going to refresh. And if there's no new tweets, it'll show you in red, no new tweets right up here. It'll show that on the screen. What's even better, let me turn that off. What's even better for this, using this tool, is that you can download this all. There's a CSV. You can export a max of 5,000 tweets. So we can download a CSV. We can download each of these charts. We can download the image of all those charts, tweets over time. We can have a sort function over here. We can also auto-refresh too. So if you're not looking at the map, you can have the same tools down here. And then you can sort the tweets by retweets, favorites, engagement, followers. I can't say enough good things about this tool. It's Social Bearing, socialbearing.com. Go check it out. And let me know what you think. Post in the comments below. Thanks for watching. This is a quick video on socialbearing.com for open source intelligence. Hope you liked the video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe to the channel so you get notified of more videos as they go up. Don't forget to go take a look at larrysnow.me for more tips, advice, tutorials on open source intelligence, business of security, and social media marketing. And download a free ebook, Branding, and Social Media Marketing for the protection professional. And I'll see you in the next video.